when he was sent down after the game. He was the first star.
Yeah.
With a couple of assists and a win over the Florida Panthers. So McEwen's been good in his previous chances. He plays with a lot of structure.
Yeah.
Which I think actually, even though the NHL game is faster, there's more structure in the NHL than the American Hockey League. It looks like a strap might have gotten underneath the skate plate of Cam Ward's for with the situation room in Toronto, and they helped them along. So you almost make a non-reviewable situation reviewable to get the right call. So when does the act of blowing the whistle start, losing sight of the puck?
Right.
And then you see that whole skate in the net, so you know, see, he's already up. He's already up with the whistle in his mouth.
But did he blow it?
But did he blow it?
And then the situation room
looked at this. This is a unique situation.
And it clearly looked like it could have crossed the line in his skate. Let's see.
Upon review of the play, the puck is caught in the goaltender's skate. His skate crosses the line completely, so we have a goal.
Yeah. That's one of the most unusual things.
Hezek gaining the line. He takes a shot. Rebound! He shipped it up in the air. It's right to go, Greece. Where's the puck? Is it in the net? The Sabres think it's in the net. The goaltender's in the net. And Mike Smith is cheating like crazy. He's trying to move his knees to move it out of there.
Watch this. Watch this. The puck's going to drop right here. Hansel tries for it. It falls right in the back of his pants.
Lord.
And watch this.
Oh,
it's laying
Lord.
In his pants, and he's going to take it right there, right into the net. You can see the puck laying on the top of his pants, on his jersey, in the net. This is going to be a good goal. You see it right there. You can see the puck right there. See it?
Yeah, I see it, but I've never seen anything like this before.
It's Christmas.
Ever.
It's Christmas.
Well, it's Christmas for one team. It's bah humbug for the other one.
The play is under review.
Yeah, I'll bet it's under review.
Review of the play. The puck did cross the line. We have a good goal.
And the Buffalo Sabres win it in overtime.
Intermission. That never happened.
Finally. Finally. I guess if he was smart, just skate right to the net.
Dive in,
go
yeah, slide
first.
In, slide in like you were going through second base. It's stuck in the skate.
At least we're fortunate before that is.
You know what, he should have drawn a penalty for cross-checking because he gets leveled while he's trying to get it out of his skate.
Fall out and fall over the line. Skinner's got a lot of quick moves, and look at that. That about says it all. He uses his ear against his shoulder in order to keep that puck from coming out. The near side post pad goes down. And then he jams his arms and his whole body up against the post in order to take it away.
You can get those.
Oh, Victor Voss with a equipment problem, we believe.
There it is.
Oh, there it is.
That's
trying to find the puck.
Problem.
That's it. Come on.
Something just doesn't feel right here.
Yeah. NHL pays for those, you know. On the back.
You take a look at his numbers, 9-2-3, 2.12, 930, as Joe mentioned in that first period. Just spectacular.
Brayden Hope, he's trying to find the puck.
It's somewhere in his pants. He'll find it, or glove. There he is. They're trying to shake it out.
Martin Brodeur had an episode like this recently in St. Louis.
Hey, where is it? Come on, where is it? They're looking in his pads, his pants. Around his jersey.
Let's not get too up close and personal with these cameras, folks.
He said, where the heck is it? He doesn't want to continue playing until he can find it. They won't let him until he finds it, Joe, because then they'll have two pucks on the ice. They're going to wait till somehow he finds the puck, and he's saying, hey, I don't have it anymore. Look in your gloves, the referee just told him.
Brayden Holtby, outstanding netminder, even better magician. Look, I can make it disappear.
He's going everywhere. Look at, he said, hey, I'm looking everywhere, guys.
He might find it in the shower in about an hour.
And they're saying, he's saying to them, no, 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 you're not allowed to look for it. Don't worry, I'll find
it. Yeah, stop frisking me. Well, I guess we'll press on. There it is.
There it is. And listen to the fans. They're loving it as much as we are up here, Joby.
Tyler Toffoli has good hands. No question about that. Toffoli in his first 11 games had 14 points. Last 21, only 9 points and 0 goals in his last 7. They can't find the biscuit. It's underneath the paraphernalia of Marty Brodeur. He's got pucks all over the place. Now he wants another one.
What did you say about CSILA?
Where's Jerry Bruckheimer? Get him back here. That's the way to kill some time. Get the fans frustrated. I can't find the puck. See, my equipment was so little, I could find the puck quite easily. Brodeur.
This is funny stuff.
You can hear them. They can't find the puck. I don't know where the puck is.
The fans are saying, look at the net. But it clearly hit Brodeur.
There it is. Just popped out.
That's why he reached so quickly to get the puck out of the mask. No rebound.
Oh, man.
No rebound whatsoever. Well, he looks like he's okay. If anything, emotionally, he might be a little startled. But right away, he took the gloves off. The blocker's going to come off right here. And he reached down there after Gomez let this high riser rip. He just let it rip. And he's trying. They're still working on getting the puck. Well, here's the situation that we got to consider. And I'm surprised Johnny Van Beesbrouck isn't warming up right now.
It's cleared back to center ice. It's in his equipment. Boy, if he went back near, maybe into his own net, that could have been a goal. And Locke, it's in the paraphernalia. Now, that's a great impression of the late, great Harry Carey. Mine earlier, that was like 5 hours ago, was very weak. But I tried, partner. Taking a lot of abuse out there, but that's okay.
I love that you tried. You even put your glasses on to do it.
Hey, by the way, where are my glasses? I lost them. You know what, Pat? I mean, Pecorini's having a tough time here. I mean, he doesn't know where this puck is. Now you got to get a little help from the linesman.
Well, they got to go get the puck.
This is like TSA at O'Hare here. He's got to find it. He's got to find it inside the gear. You can't go back into a blue paint without the puck. Now he's going up the back of his pants.
Where's Waldo?
You got car keys in there or what? I mean, what else does he have? Now, I'm kind of surprised, Pat, first off. I mean, eventually you're going to find the puck at some point here. But I'm surprised that he went out, Pat, with that puck being in the glass.
Yeah. You've talked about it a lot for goalies to not do that because of a potential bad bounce off a stanchion. And generally in this series, and certainly for the most part tonight, he's not done that. So this kind of a rarity for him to, when the puck's up high, to go out and try to stop it himself. But we mentioned this a lot, and if he likes to come out of the net and play the puck, he usually thinks he's pretty good at it. So yeah.
Well, there it is, Pat, and clearly
It wasn't up on the glass, so you can see why it did come up.
I think what happened, Pat, when it initially got shot in, it was up in the glass, and then it just went down. Not in his pants. We clearly saw that. I mean, he's checking. Well, just for people that might know, there are more than one puck. It's almost like playing at home, Pat, you know, where you lost all the pucks. And
if you shoot it in the snowbank, yeah, exactly. Game's over.
You got to wait till June. There it is.
Hey, attaboy, Pekka.
Pekka had a puck in a pocket.
Burns gets the puck through better than any other defenseman in the National Hockey League. There's a deflection, and instead of Elliott having to make the save, it goes right up the pant leg of Joe Thornton. He's on the bench. The trainer's got his jersey up. It's in here someplace. Brian, help him out.
I don't know how he doesn't feel it somewhere in his equipment.
They might have to use their timeout.
What a start to the series.
How about this?
To the corner, Johansson now across for Saw. Down low, across, and did Lundqvist make that stop?
That's unbelievable. That is an unbelievable save. This was an unbelievable save. It was beautiful passing by the Columbus Blue Jackets. And how Lundqvist was able to keep this puck out of the net.
He's checking to see if it's caught up in his equipment.
That's how.
Yeah, Ryan McDonough was watching the scoreboard to see if he could tell where the puck ended up getting lost.
Hartnell went and looked in the net. He thought, well, maybe it's in there. Nobody can find it. Lundqvist is saying, I don't know where it is. It's in there someplace. It's not in the net.
Play is under review, and they're also trying to figure out, forget if it went in the net or not, where is it?
I mean, he's got to check, because sometimes you can feel where it is. Not in this case. Hands, no. Pants, no. There it is.
There it is.
In, but look at Jared Smithson. Great vision there. I think Dave Bolin, 36 and red, was anticipating Smithson to throw the puck in behind the net. Once Bolin left, Spalling was there, and Antti Niemi with a real good stop.
And Nick Spalling's a guy, his last year junior, playing for the Kitchener Rangers in the Ontario Hockey League, had 38 goals in 56 games. He's the guy that clearly knows how to find the back of the net. He's taken with a 58th pick in the 2007 entry draft, second-year pro. And you know, the one thing about Nashville, fellas, we know about the great stories in Chicago, how they've built their team through the draft in Nashville. They have done a fantastic job, David Boyle and his scouts.
Well, after that stop from Nick Spalling and Team Niemi's, they're trying to find the puck. They can't find it.
Just call him Pac-Man, he gobbled it up.
Well, just make sure this puck isn't in the back of the net somewhere. There are no pockets in those pants, folks. I think we need a GPS for that.
Somewhere there are some TSA officials about to go to work at O'Hare for the 3 o'clock shift that are saying we need a metal detector.
This is going to make every highlight film around the world.
Listen to the crowd.
Maybe he'll have to do what happened in Slapshot at the end.
Well, I don't think that they can start this game without them finding that puck, because if that puck comes loose and when he's going from side to side at any time in game, you're going to have two pucks out there. So I think they want to make sure they got to try to find this puck. But here comes the captain, Jonathan Toews, lifts up the jersey, and there the puck drops right out of his jersey. It almost seemed like Antti Niemi was giving birth there to that puck there.
Look it up in his pants.
Look what I found. It's in there somewhere.
There it is.
This year, Minnesota's been on the wrong end of four of them. Stall to Stewart, a shot! Saved by Jones. Is he over the line or not? No signal from the officials. Jones made this save, but he may well have been over the red line himself with the puck.
It's in his jersey and his back. How could you tell if his back was over the line? My goodness. That's going to be a lot of fun to take a look at.
If it's in the back of his jersey, I believe this will be a goal, because he was awfully close, and actually, now that I see a second look at it, I think he was outside the goal line.
Yeah, well, you look, it hits him, and it goes right into his jersey. It just catches, and he does stay out of the net.
We're here to determine if the puck crossed the line.
Look at the jersey ruffle right where his name tag is, and now it's in his jersey. And how can you tell where the puck is? I mean, is it on the name tag, or did it drop down to the number? Is it still in his neck area? Who knows?
It looked to me like it got caught just below the Anon Jones,
the nameplate,
and
yep.
Therefore it's outside the net. And that there's no definitive way they'll be able to look at this and say they know that it's over the line.
That is just incredible.
Not cross the goal line, no goal.
Yeah, you've seen saves from goaltenders for years and years and years. This is likely the first one you'll ever see that was made by the neck of the sweater and the nameplate. You can see it just trapped up there above the nameplate, but my goodness.
Spezza has a goal and an assist, but cannot win this faceoff. Goodrow goes across the ice. Eves blocked it down. Hunter shot it in. That hits Nemeth.
In the face. Look at that, man.
Wow. What is it with Patrick Nemeth this year? You can't keep your eye on the puck more bullseye than this. It hits him in the face, rides right up into his visor. Looks like he had a patch on. He looks like a pirate. He does.